Hello everyone. Just one second. Hello. Yes. Okay. It's audio. I welcome everyone for the 10th day session. Today we are going to discuss about the Iris. Iris is yet another Python library similar to CDAT. And how to use the CDO, that client data operator, inside Python. Also, finally, I'll touch up on the usage of Python in NCMWF. So, as per the So if you search Python Iris, then you'll be getting example here. So this is the Iris library. It's mainly using this matplotlib and cutopy to do the visualization. Also, we can do like a similar operation whatever we think we did it using CDAT. Similarly, we can do it using Iris also. But CDAT is launched in 1999 something. But this Iris is a very latest one, recently released. So it may not have all the functionalities like a CDAT, but all the major functionalities are there, like nominal, mean, minimum, max, or weighted average, interpolation, regrading. Everything is there. So I'll be just showcasing using a few of them. And this also built over NumPy. And Dask is yet another framework through web server itself, we can do all the plotting. That's a Dask package. So installation is simple. You can do pip install, or you can go it here. You can see that in Conda install or pip install, you can do it. Mainly, as I mentioned, this Iris is very useful to read the unified model outputs, weather forecasting outputs. Also, it is very useful to write in terms of GRIP2. It can write both GRIP2 and PP file. Also, it can write FF file. Also, it can write and GRIP2 format. It can write and NetCDF file format. It can write. So, all the four it can. It is very useful to write. So I just going into my HPC. So in Maker HPC, also in Busker HPC, we have Iris modules. So one of them, I'm going to load it. And as I mentioned earlier, whether CDAT or Iris, if you are going to load it, make sure you don't have any Python exported at your bash RC. If you already have it, then take backup and then make clean bash RC. And then do this loading. Otherwise, some of the Python libraries getting conflict and it will not work. So this is user specific. This first one I'm going to use it. Just to module load. So just load it. So I have some few on like today's NFID model outputs are there. For example, let me take a PF file or PB file, like this PB file. So you have seen that there are multiple 6 hourly files are there. So I'm just doing my import iris. So this is the method, like you can do iris.load the file name and it will be assigned to some file name. Let me go to documentation. So they have given very detailed documentation. You can go with this. Okay, this is the, in iris they used to call it as a cubes. Once we loaded all the files, the variable in C that we used to call it as a variable, here they are calling it as a cubes, that all the NumPy and with meta information that they're calling it as a cube. And it has a dimension coordinate and auxiliary coordinate. So this is the cube, like our three-dimensional NumPy or dimensional NumPy array, and with variable name and latitude and longitude, like this, latitude, longitude, height or pressure level. So this is the cube that they are calling. So once we loaded, once we printed, we will get all the meta information like this. Let me go and do that. I just loaded this one file into cubes, or I'm just calling it as F. So I'm just printing F. I hope this font is visible. So you can see that there are some total 37, 0 to 37, so 38 variables available in this file. So you can see that some of them having proper name. This is standard name. Like air temperature, that's a minimum and maximum, and atmospheric mass content of water, cloud base height, dew point, relative humidity. Like you can see all of them. So some of them, this is called stash. The stash is generally belongs to unified model. So these few of the stash doesn't show the proper if you're just loading it, it doesn't show the proper standard name. But if you are using EOM Rider, which I created, that will show all the meta information properly, because while loading, we are fixing those meta information. That I will show maybe next time, not now, because this studio class is just an introduction to the Iris, not the EOM Rider. So let me open this 16. So if I just printing this 16 index, you can get the air temperature. Then it shows time dimension is 8, time dimension, latitude and longitude. Since this is a very high resolution data, like a 0.17 cross 0.18, sorry, 12 degree by 18 degree. So time dimension, you can see that, and latitude, longitude, also auxiliary coordinates, some like a forecast period, but also there, and a forecast reference time, like today is 00 reference time, and it's just a height at another coordinate. It's a 2 meter height or 1.5 meter height from the ground. And this is the stash. And this is the source of the MetOffice model. And this is the EOM version 10.8. And cell method, it's a maximum. Cell method in the sense, how it is post-processed or how it is processed. This is the maximum in hour. So this is having hourly temporal resolution. So within hour, what is the maximum? Suppose if you are taking the minimum one, the next one, it is minimum. So for the mean case, it will be mean. So cell method, in temporal, it's just doing the maximum and minimum. Suppose if you are doing area average or any specific zonal average, then that also will be, it has to be recorded at cell methods. So if you are giving this post-processed files to some other institute, they will come to know how it is being post-processed. So that's the purpose of keeping the track of the meta information cell methods. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to extract the coordinates. Suppose this forecast period, I want to extract. So there is this cube or this object dot coordinates. Within that, what coordinate we want. So that is showing like this, like a forecast period. If you're extracting time. So this is a basic time, and this is in terms of forecast period. Let me check, this is okay, it doesn't have that. So similarly, you can extract a latitude. You can see that latitude goes from minus 89 to 89, and similar longitude also you can get it. So as you've seen that this is time, time dimension having 8. This single file contains 8 time dimension. Suppose if I want to load multiple files, all the PB, I can put star. So now, right now we have some like a 40 PB files, everything loaded together. Now, if you see that, you can see that 84. Previously it was just 8, now it become 84. Temporal is just loading all together and then bringing to single cube, proper single cube, merging all different different PP files together. So this is yet another advantage in iris. Now you can, if you want to subset any particular latitude, longitude, then you can go through this documentation. So once you go through this, at least once this entire documentation, then it will be very easy for you to further use of this iris. Suppose let me come to this example. So here, see that what they are doing, they are just importing iris.analysis. Then you can do collapse, this cube.collapse at what this is coordinate, and then what is your stats method which you are want to calculate. So let us do this. So I just imported this and I have 84 time dimension. I'm going to do I'm going to find the maximum out of entire next 10 days. So I want to pass the argument as what coordinate, just time coordinate, then iris dot analysis dot max. So it takes some time because it's 84 and it's a very, very high resolution data. So once it is done, it just again bringing all the meta information of latitude, longitude. Over 84 hours, it is taking the finding the maximum. So now you can see that the time dimension has been removed because we did the temporal maximum. So now you can see that the cell method, again, it is being added. So it's already maximum time temporal at 1 hour. Now again, we made another maximum out of 84 temporal, 84 hours. We calculated what is the maximum like from next 10 days, what is the maximum we calculated. So it's that meta information also added automatically. So similarly, you can do all the basic analysis. Basic stats analysis can be done, or if you want to do area average, that also can be done. So I would suggest you to just go with this example and do it yourself. Make that your hands by doing the exploring these examples. Because we have, it will load all the NC files or whatever GRIP files. Also, it can be read or PP file, FF file. Once you load your meta information or your actual data, either climate data or weather data, you can do all the exercise. So let me show you how to save it. So it can support NetCDF and GRIP version 2. And MetaOffice proprietary version of PP file. So now it has, we calculated some Tmax. Let me store this. So it just stored it. What it shows, it's giving some warning. It's fine. Iris.save, whatever the processed cube or whatever the cube, actual cube, then your absolute path of grip2 file. So since we are ending with the .grip2, it will be saved into grip2 file. Or if you're keeping with the NC, then it will be saved in terms of netcdio file. It just got aborted. It's fine then. Okay, it's just here. So we just stored this. Then using wgrip2 command, you can see that what it contains. Sorry, didn't store it properly. I will reload it one more time. Yeah, now it is created. You can see that this, because I just loaded the first PP file and it contains all the eight hours temporal of Tmax. You can do -V, then you can see that it says a temperature 2 meter above ground. If you do V2, then it would say further example. If you do capital V, so it shows that what is our resolution, 2048 by 1536. And we'll start from 89, minus 89 to 89, and with the interval of latitude at this 0.117188, similar longitude, it's a 0.175. So that's why we used to call it as a 12 degree high resolution data. So similarly, you can go with this this high risk saving example. You can store into PP file also an NC file. Like if you just store with .pp, it will write into PP format. You can append into grip2 and PP file using append command. But in netcdf, we can't append it as of now in high risk. Or if you're writing into a netcdio file format, you can mention .nc file and netcdio format, which one you want, netcdio 3 classic or netcdio general one. So this is a plotting example that I have given using matplotlib. It's a very simple way to plot it. So if you understand matplotlib and iris together, it's very easy to do your other stuff. Yeah, they have given examples, but you have to do it yourself. I'll just show you some of the product which we are using iris and dotting operate at our center. I'll show you in a while. So you have to read documentation yourself. We can do more, whatever I showed in the past 4 days, that also we can be done using iris, like most of the stuff. So now I'll go with the CDO, how to use CDO inside Python. On the day itself, I think I showed demo, but still I'll show demo for using CDO. Come to my area. The CDO is there already. So I have error file data which I calculated daily, from hourly to daily I already calculated. Let me open what it contains. CDOS info. So here I'm not teaching CDO, I'm just showing how to use CDO inside Python. Okay, it contains our daily data. I kept it 2000. This daily data it contains, and it contains this much resolution, like 0.25 by 0.25. Suppose if you want to do any CDO operation, like so it's a climate data operators. You can go with this. This is the official wiki documentation page. You can get the wiki, go to wiki and documentation. So there are more than 100, I forget how many, but there are more than 100 operators available using this CDO. This CDO is in general built using C++ programming language. They made it, and this also comes under GNU public license. And the advantage of CDO is it's by default, it's compiled with the parallel computing. So it's much faster and it's available in all the platform, Mac, Windows, Linux. Also it's available in Conda, Anaconda, and Docker, which I mentioned earlier, that's cloud and HPC. So let me show you some of the examples. Suppose if I want to do finding maximum of this already Tmax, daily Tmax, if you want to compute monthly maximum. So the command is, we can do time max or month max. So many operations available. Then your input file, then output file. So I just computed the maximum of December and just return using time 31 time steps. It just calculated time max and it has been stored it here. So now you can see that it just having only one time step and that is the maximum, and general in CDO just right in the middle of your temporal operation. So I just wrote at the 16th day of your 12th month. So my intention is I need to calculate for all the NC files. So there are total 480 NC files. So how I'm going to do, how I should do it using Python. So in CDO, it just calculated in a single line, but I need to repeat this for all the 480 NC files separately. So first of all, let me create some folder. So I just created this folder. And this is my NC file. So I'm just going to use in a shell itself. I'll be using this. So I'm just store this out path. Then in file is so in file I no need to worry for the in file. So what I'm going to do files. I'm just loading all, I'm just listing out. It contains all the NC files, input files. So I'm just writing in a loop what I want to do, like in files. So I should get out file also. So before that, I'm just using this CDO time sum. So it is this in file containing the daily maximum temperature for individual months. So within that, I'm making the maximum of month wise. So this is in file. So this in file will be replaced here and out file. So I'm just concatenating this same file name, I'm keeping it, but output will be at out path which I mentioned at the initial of this script. I imported this subprocess. This also I showed demo few days back. I'm just displaying in file. So there are 480 input files are there, and this will be just created. Okay, it shows some warning. Some data values or outside. Yes. Okay, it shows that it's outside the this integer threshold is in C it will goes from -3,2768 to +3,2767. So we have to make it as a 64 bit. So we need to specify it here. So now this will be writing the output and see files in the double precision. Yeah, now it is just doing the all the works. So what we are doing eventually from daily maximum to from daily files, we are calculating monthly maximum. So similar 480 files will be created at my desired location. So let me go to this area. So you can see that it's a work you can do. So you can see that how these new files are being created. So it's keep on creating, like here it's just still going on. So the idea is whatever you are doing it in CDO in a normal shell, in normal bash shell, the same command you have to bring inside your Python so that we can use it. So I prefer to use subprocess. So that subprocess will wait till the command execution is over. So we are passing second argument shell is equal true and it will wait till the finishing of this execution of that individual program. So similarly, you can run even your grad script also, you can run inside your Python. Or if you are running your R code also you can run it in Python. And for this CDO, we can import CDO Python also. There are some modules available in CDO Python. So we can import CDO package inside Python. Just import CDO package. And then you can pass all the arguments as a Python program, Python function itself, we can pass it. But I'm very newbie to this CDO, like a past 1 year only I'm using it. So I prefer to use a command as it is, and then that command I'll just bring inside Python. So I'll be utilizing both the language. So now it has done. So 480 files are being created. Now you can see that it contains only one time step, each month containing only its maximum. If you do max info, then you can see that. You can just show where. So it is having Tmax. So similarly, you can do all the operations in CDO. CDO also having more than 100. And let me open that CDO. So there is something called CDO cheat sheet. This you can call it as a reference card. This also will be very useful. But I found some, like, you can see that what is this operator name and just minimal information they have given. More detailed documentation, you can get it. In CDO also, you can do EOF, those kind of statistical operation, you can do it. You can do masking or interpolation. There are multiple methods available for the interpolation or stats also. There is the, like, you can do even running mean filter, you can do it. Like, there are regressions, D trend, EOF. But I used to have a single page cheat sheet is there. And detailed PDF also there. And moreover, in CDO, one more sub project is there in CDO that's called the climate indices. If you search climate indices, yes, using this ECA package, you can use so there are these many, nearly 28 to 30 climate indices available. You can use all of them. Like, you can get the cold days percentage with respect to some 10th percentile of reference period, or warm days, cold nights, warm nights, or heat wave duration index. These are all based on, they have given how to calculate. It's not applicable to Indian domain, but it's just applicable to the general accepted by the climate community. So it's already 446. With this, I'll just, you can do all the operations using CDO, and whatever you are doing, you can bring it into in your Python. So you can speed up your work. Now I'll come to usage of Python at NCMRWF. This is our website, National Center for Medium Range Weather Forecasting. Let me go to product. And if you go to latest chart, so this is just a latest chart link. It used to have only the latest date forecast and a few verifications. So I'm not showing detailed demo. I'm just showing in whatever the products are created by the Python. I'm just showing this. So first one, let me go to this. So severe weather monitoring. And this is created by me using CDAT. This everything's plotted through CDAT and VCS. This is today's forecast, like a day one forecast based on today's initial condition. You can get the maximum or greater than 90th percentile precipitation, extreme precipitation, and winds, extreme winds. Similarly, warm location and cold locations. You can see it for, so this is a heavy wind or cold days, cold locations and warm locations. This is being created using CDAT and VCS. Similarly, like this one, this is the original model. This is the lightning product. This is 3-hourly lightning, and this is created by team of Dr. Jayakumar and Dr. Sandeep. also by Shaji sir using iris. What I showed today using iris and matplotlib, they plotted this operation. It's done. And similarly, this entire regional, most of them using this Python and iris only. Let me go to weather outlook. So you can see that this kind of quality figures can be created using matplotlib and in general Python. What are package you are using, either CDAT or iris. You can see that wind gust and concentration, AOD and total lightning flashes in next 24 hours. So this entire lines created by Python. And one more thing, this is ensemble or ensemble model. This is MJO, monitoring, real-time monitoring. And this also created by me using CDAT and XMGrace. You can see how quality figures you can create using this XMGrace. So currently we are like this figure started from February 25th onwards. This orange is going like this. Then March started from here, this phase. Yeah, and then it's moving towards anticyclone. Then 25th March, yes, it's going like this. Then it's coming here. 15th March, it has gone into weak MJO. Then further, it comes to Indian Ocean from 19th to 24th March. Then April started here. Just from here, it's a ensemble forecast. You can see that red line is the control deterministic model, and the light greens are ensemble, 23 members, and dark green is the member average. This is based on today's initial condition, and this is based on yesterday's initial condition. So you can see that little bit. So you can see that this is based on initial condition. Yeah, analysis is from February 12th to March 22nd, and initial condition from next forecast from initial condition based on 22nd, and forecast days from 23rd to 1st April. Similarly, you can see that all every dates keep on moving. So in general, our model is doing good. Like in 10 days before, it predicted the path will go in this way. We'll move this phase. So, and yet another, this is MJO verification. So you can see that verification. So here the black line is observed and analysis, and others are a forecast. So we can see that at least some 4 or 5 days is tracks are very good. So that see that this is observed, whereas the others are forecast. See that this is the observed and forecast error. So there are multiple products used for this Python, and few other products are used by grads and by some other scientists. And even this IMD and then some have collaborated for this real-time satellite observation for the Lightning and many other products available at the IMD website. But it's a close to IMD people only, not for the public. But if you see it in public website of IMD and few of the products, plots are generated by our NCMR developer people. And that also, this figure also being created by using Python. There are multiple Python packages available to handle the satellite data and plotted using matplotlib. And moreover, I forget to mention that if you go to Tigi, Tigi, we are submitting our forecast model since 2017 August onwards. You can see that NCMRWF. You can download on real time, at least in 2 days lag, you can download all the most of the variables you can download. And this, you can select and download control files and attribute forecast and forecast. And we are the only institution giving the very high resolution ensemble forecast to the Tiki community. Although NSAP is doing high resolution, but in Tiki they are not contributing for the forecast. We are giving it both 00 and 12 cycle. If you select say March, so there are 11 members available at 0th cycle, and 12th cycle also another 11 members will be available, and available up to 240 six at 6 hourly interval. You can download all these variables. Even pressure level also there, you can choose here. So this is yet another contribution made because of Python. I used IRIS and CDAT, WGRIP2 also together to make this product available. And moreover, all the NCMRWF plot products, like our clients are there, international clients and national clients are there. In national, IMD is the main client, and INCOIS, SAC, Navy, and few like a NIVO, National Institute of Energy Resource, Renewable Energy Centers. So most of them are using our product for their further diagnostics. And all of them created by using Python and WGRIP2. So let me come to a question session. So I already sent you mail, but I don't know either all of you received the mail or not. So use this link to get more information regarding all the links I kept in this pad. If it is not loading, just reload it, it will load it. So I mentioned already all the presentation links are here. And GitHub source code, whatever made by Mahalakshmi, this source code is here. Also, I mentioned the homework problems that you can do it. And see that installation procedure also I kept here. And somebody asked yesterday, somebody gave feedback that they are not able to load some of the YouTube or YouTube videos are not audible as Zoom videos. So for them, we created a separate playlist, and yesterday, today's also will be uploaded there. All the first day I forget to record in the Zoom, but from day 2 to day 10, it will be available. You can use this link. Or if you want to go with the YouTube recorded one, live record, you can go watch on this day 1 to day 5, this playlist is there, and day 6 to day 10, this separate playlist is there. And kindly give feedback for the CDAT session. Use this link, give to feedback, and also for Python. Two separate feedback form is there. And today's question, is there any ready-made module or command available for converting any ASCII data set to NC? So in general, we don't have such a ready-made solution because your ASCII having different structure, and some other people ASCII have different structure. So in general, we can't make such a general solution. If we have general specific ASCII, like some of the products are being only written in ASCII, then one can make it. So if you give some more specific question, then I can talk in that detail. Suppose if we have some data assimilation, people might be receiving the information as a ASCII file. So you have to write your own code and then make it available to the public so that other people can come and use it. So for your specific data assimilation input file or ASCII files can be write into NC file by reading all the rows and columns properly, and then make it as a variable. Either you can go with the CDAT or IRIS, whatever way you are going, but you have to make it as either CDMS 2 variable or a IRIS cube, then you can write into NC file. Do we have any other question? So I would suggest if you are making this, whoever asked this question, make it as a module and write into your GitHub so that other people can, they don't need to rewrite the same function. Yes, you can share all the videos. All the videos and presentation are made at Creative Commons license. So you can share to the students or those whoever want, you can share it. All of them available at Creative Commons license. So today is the last day. I thank everyone. I'm happy that even my wife also happy for attended, those who were attended the class and those who were watching at YouTube, even the live one, also the recorded one. Is there any question at? There is no question at Zoom. And just reminding that this page will be deleted automatically after 7 days of inactive. So if you want to take any backup from this page, this question session, you can just copy and download, copy and paste at your hand. And what else? For one more time, I'll just send mail of these links. There is some problem at our end. Emails, many people, whatever I'm sending, many people not receive the email. So after some time, like maybe 1 or 2 weeks, I'll just send you all the links, whatever we made it here, and try to do this homework. So you have to make dirty your hand. That's what I'm keep on repeating. So whatever error throws, you have to resolve by yourself. Then only you can become master. See, nobody taught me Python to me. Just 1 hour, my brother, elder brother, just he started the idea of Python 10 years before. Then myself started learning this Python. And finally, I forget to mention that if you have any questions in Python, there are, in general, there are groups are available, whatever locations you are residing. I'm bet sure there would be Python group. So you have to, you can join in, like see that you can PyDaily. PyDaily and NCR Python. You can go to this GitHub PyDaily. Whatever location you are residing in the world, you'll get, you can see that some near to your location, Python groups would be there. You can join in there. Mailing list, you can join and ask your questions. And initially this is created by me 10 years before, but still people are using, interacting in the mailing list. You can ask your general question in Python. And those groups used to make some monthly meetup or weekly meetup or annual meetup. And not only for Python, for CDAT also there is mailing list. You can go with the CDAT mailing list. You can join and ask your questions. Similarly for IRIS also, some Google group mailing list is there. You can post your questions there. So this is the mailing list is available. You can join and ask your questions if you have any doubt. Yes, it's already 5. So with this, I thank you once again, everyone. And do give feedback. In that feedback form, I just asked like in future classes topic. If you are something interested to learn something in atmospheric science, you can give feedback here. Then I will take this to my colleagues, senior scientists, those who are interested to give, take classes. Then again, we will send mail for the notification. You can come and register. And finally, I would like to thank my office in NCMRWF head, Dr. E. N. Rajagopal, who gave permission to utilize the paid version of Zoom. I thank him. And I also thank my wife who took classes for the initial days. I was getting bored to take classes for Python. I took many, many times. So I asked my wife to take. This time she handled the class. So you can give feedback to both the forms, Python and CDAT. So the future classes, maybe not this month, maybe next month we can plan. So well, thank you once again. See you next time. I don't know when we will schedule it, but if you subscribe to our channel, then you'll get notification. Magalakshmi already uploaded some 100 videos related to Python and data structure in Tamil and English, at least 50 of them in English. You can go to channel and you can forward this to those who over need. So thank you. Thank you, everyone.